Hi again. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a form with a subform. So basically a form that's based off of multiple tables and a query. I just want to go over the query that the subform is going to be used for. This is the extended price. I'm going to zoom in here and show you the extended price calculated field that's going to be used in the form. So let's close that and close the appointment subform query. Now let's go create. We'll use the form wizard. And first we're going to pull in the fields from the appointment table. Essentially this is going to be an appointment form that's going to allow us to create appointments, select the customer and their pet. And so we need to find the customer. We're pulling the customer here from the table pet because we want the customer to be associated with the pet, otherwise it will be an orphaned table in this form. So go ahead and add in the customer ID from the pet table, and then finally we're going to use the query new appointment subform and add in all of those fields as well. Click next. Here we want our data to be viewed by appointment. That is what the purpose of this form is for, is to add appointments. Click next. We're going to leave it in Datasheet View for our subform. And let's call it Form New Appointment. And for our subform, I'll call it New Appointment Subform. And let's take a look at it. So we can see the subform is down here. A number of the fields are being cut off, and the layout isn't great. But this form actually does tell us quite a bit of information. So we can select the customer and then add an appointment. It also lists the pet and which vet has been seeing that pet. So it's quite a useful form to allow us to add new appointments. Let's update it in Design View so that we can see the fields a little bit clearer. So into Design View, first thing we're going to do is remove this Form New Appointment label and drag over our subform, giving it a little bit more space. You'll notice that the view of the subform here in Design View is quite a bit different than in the layout view. So it's hard to format it or to know what it will look like when you format it here in Design View. But we will do that in Layout View in just a second. Let's change the heading to New Appointment. And we will drag it to the center of our form header and then center align it. Let's make it black, bold, so we can see it a bit clearer, and let's save those changes. Let's go into Layout View. Now we can see some more of our fields here, but it's not ideal. So instead what we're going to do is we're going to change the labels, and we can minimize the field size here by just using our double-headed arrow. But let's go back into Design View and actually change the label numbers. So back into Design View, we're going to change the label just to units, and we'll go unit price for the service fee label. We can just go ID here, and that should give us a little bit more flexibility with our column widths. Back into Layout View. Now we may want to change this to be appointment date, which is what's pulling. And service would be make more sense than service ID. So let's make those two changes and then we will save. So here we're going to change this just to service, and instead of appointment ID, we'll set it to appointment date. Save and take a look in Form View. Oh, we still need a little bit more space here to show the extended price. So back into Layout, let's minimize the column widths so that we can see our extended price field here. Save. Always testing the final result. This is what the form looks like in Form View. Oh, our header is too tall. So let's minimize our heading here and the header space as well. That looks much better. So save and close.